Hey guys, in this video, I want to talk about the statement of cash flows. I want to talk about the three kinds of cash flows and how you can read a company's statement of cash flows to better understand where their cash goes. Okay, so this video really has two parts. First, I'm going to talk about the difference between the cash a company generates in a given year and their accounting profits, because a lot of people think that's the same thing and it's very different, and so I want to discuss that a little bit. If you already know about that, you can skip to the next section, which is going to be all about the statement of cash flows. Okay, so let's do a little example so you can see that accounting income is very different from cash flows. So we got Cash Money Industries is a startup, and here's some details about Mr. Cash Money. He started off raising $200K with his IPO. He also borrowed some money from a bank. Then he bought a factory for about $100K. It's supposed to last him about 40 years. And then he pays about $2,000 a month for rent for his store in downtown Houston. He hires some workers. He ends up paying them about $120,000 for the year. He sold about $170,000 worth of apparel this year, but he only collected $80,000 of that, with $90,000 being sold on credit. So the question is, what is Cash Money Industries income for this year? And you can pause the video and try and figure it out yourself, or you can just get the answer. But I think you get the idea here that it's not so clear. First of all, sometimes when you get money, that's not income. So when you borrow money, would it be fair to put that on my income statement? $75,000 of revenue there because I borrowed from a bank? No, not at all. That's one reason why income is not the same as cash flows. But there's a few other reasons. Let's have a look at the solution. Here's the actual answer under accounting standards in the United States. This would be your answer here. The revenues are 170, even though you only collected 80 of it. The fact is you sold 170 this year. As far as expenses, you can see we don't have any expense for buying that big building. We just depreciate it slowly over time. So that 100K building, I gotta spread that over 40 years. So I just gotta do expense 1/40th of it this year. Rent expense, pretty standard, $2,000 a month times 12 months. And you end up with operating income of $23,500. So what this example really illustrates is that accounting income is based on the amount of revenue you actually earn in the period, not the amount of cash you actually collect. And as far as expenses go, these are the expenses that you incur during the period, not necessarily the amount of money that comes out of your company's pockets. So accounting income is great. It's usually a better indicator of how the company is doing. But you do have to be careful. You need to look at their statement of cash flows to make sure that they're actually converting, you know, resources into cash. Okay, so onto the statement of cash flows. It really has three sections, three parts to it. You got operating cash flows, investing cash flows, and financing cash flows. If you add them all together, that's going to be equal to the change in cash for the period. I'm going to talk about them kind of in reverse order, because the first one, operating cash flow section, is actually the hardest to understand for most people. So financing cash flows are pretty easy to understand. Company needs financing. That means they have to either borrow money, that's debt, or they have to go to the equity market, issue stock, that's equity. So any money you get from borrowing or issuing new shares, that's a positive financing cash flow. And any money you spend, you know, paying back that debt or buying back your own shares or paying dividends, that's a negative financing cash flow. You're giving money back to those equity holders or debt holders. The second section is the investing cash flow section. So whenever you buy a piece of property, plant, or equipment, that is a negative cash flow. It's a negative investing cash flow. Conversely, if you sell a piece of land or a piece of equipment, that's going to be a positive investing cash flow. In addition, if you have extra money and you just want to buy some securities or something, that's going to be a negative investing cash flow. When you sell those securities, that's a positive investing cash flow. So far, so good. Pretty simple, right? Then you get to the operating cash flow section. Cash from operations includes all the money you spend on your inventory, money you spend to pay your employees, you know, R&D expense, advertising expense, you know, any money you spend on any of that stuff for your operations, and the money that comes in through selling things to customers, that's going to be a positive operating cash flow. Something cool about the statement of cash flows is that it allows you to assess what life cycle stage a company is in based on the direction of those cash flows. So here I'm looking at the 3M company, which is no doubt a stable, mature company. And you can see that in the cash flows. Their financing cash flows are negative in pretty much every year, which we would expect. Companies in this stage of the life cycle are usually paying out dividends to shareholders. It's going to be negative financing cash flow. Sometimes they're paying debt back or repurchasing shares. All of those things lead to negative financing cash flows. You can also see in red here, they have positive investing cash flows. You can only really see that type of thing in a company that is mature or declining. They're actually, on the whole, selling more of their investments than they are making new investments. And that's why the red line is always above zero. And finally, in blue, another stage of a mature company is that they have positive operating cash flows, which are pretty stable over time. It's a very different story over at Salesforce. Salesforce is an up-and-comer. They are a growth firm. I wish I had data going further back for them, but I don't. What you can see here is, you know, as far as back as 9 years ago, they were already generating positive operating cash flows. And you can see those increasing as they've grown. They have negative investing cash flows in most years, which is very common for a growth company. They are making investments every year. And finally, in the green, you can see their financing cash flows are positive in most years, indicating that they're still needing to raise money from shareholders or borrow money more so than they're paying it back. Finally, just as another look, here is AMD's cash flows over the past 10 years. And you can see that they've had their struggles with negative operating cash flows in blue, which have finally turned positive recently. And the financing cash flows in green there are very positive for most years. So they've really had to go back to the equity markets to raise money. And you can also see positive investment cash flows in most years, which is very interesting. I would argue, though, that a lot of their, quote, investments are not going to be classified as investments on a traditional statement of cash flows. What I mean by that is they do a lot of research and development. So just got to keep that in mind as we view this. So here is an operating cash flow section for the 3M company. And I've taught this a number of times over the years. As you guys know, I am a college professor. What I can say is this is probably the most confusing thing to people. You see, you start at net income and you make a lot of adjustments and you end up at cash from operations. So they're very different things. Those adjustments are what we call accruals, and it boils down to the timing of cash flows. So in our little example earlier, we had Mr. Cash Money of Cash Money Industries, and he sold some apparel and he didn't collect all the money from those sales. Well, you know, as far as calculating the net income number, we would include all the revenues from those sales. But if I want to calculate the cash from operations, I would only include the actual cash received from those sales. So that would be one of those adjustments there. And that would be this adjustment right here, changes in accounts receivable. And so we do a bunch of those adjustments for what we call accruals, and we get from net income to operating cash flows. As I scroll down here, I can see the investing and financing sections of the statement of cash flows for the 3M company. And what we can see here again is overall negative cash flows from investments. So you got things like capital expenditures, which are negative. That is a negative cash flow. Offsetting that is, you know, money you get from selling property, plant, and equipment. You've got cash acquisitions, usually negative, divestitures, big word, which means the opposite of acquiring. And you've got extra money they had to buy marketable securities. For the financing section, it's as you would think, You know, you got debt issuances resulting in positive cash flows, debt being repaid resulting in negative cash flows. You issue common stock, that's positive. You repurchase it, that's going to be negative. And you've got dividends, which are negative. If you guys are enjoying that content so far, please hit that like button. It helps me a lot. Also hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. Okay, so how can we use the statement of cash flows to evaluate a company? Well, for one, you can look at the pattern of cash flows that we, as we did in those charts I showed you earlier. But also, you can look at all the details. This is very important. A company that continually needs to go get new financing is not a sustainable business venture. They eventually need to generate positive operating cash flows. You know, hopefully very positive operating cash flows. Similarly, it's important to pay attention to how much money the company needs to plow back into its business via investing cash flows. You know, we would like to see our ideal business here would generate massive operating cash flows with minimal reinvestment and not need to go back to financing market again. That's an ideal company there. Not too many of those around, but they do exist. But it is important to pay attention to. Another thing we can look out for is heavy level of investments. You know, a company's income statement may not look very pretty, but if we look at the statement of cash flows and we see that, yes, they are doing a lot of acquisitions, they're doing a lot of, you know, investments in equipment and factories, you know, that could be a signal that good things are to come, and that's something we should consider. Okay, well, that's all I got for this video. I hope you guys learned something. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you find it useful for your investments. Thank you for watching.